the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to the last life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, giver of that ardor of love for you, by which St. Lawrence was outstandingly faithful in service and gracious in martyrdom, grant that we may love what he loved and put into practice what he taught through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians and to us. Brothers and sisters, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each must do as already determined, without sadness or compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. Moreover, God is able to make every grace abundant for you, so that in all things, always having all you need, you may have an abundance for every good work. As it is written, he scatters abroad, he gives to the poor, his righteousness endures forever. The one who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed and increase the harvest of your righteousness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm response, blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. Blessed the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands. His posterity shall be mighty upon the earth. The upright generation shall be blessed. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. Well for the man who is gracious and lends, who conducts his affairs with justice. He shall never be moved. The just one shall be an everlasting remembrance. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. An evil report he shall not fear. His heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. His heart is steadfast. He shall not hear till he looks adown upon his foes. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. Lavishly he gives to the poor. His generosity shall endure forever. His horn shall be exalted in glory. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life, says the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat, but if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it, and whoever hates his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also will my servant be. The Father will honor whoever gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God, the giver of all good gifts, has given us everything. What we give him in return, he will multiply for the sake of the world. As with a grain of wheat, the Lord will bring forth great fruit from our dying self and serving him. With trust in our loving God, let us bring him our prayers for Pope Francis and church leaders. May the Lord give them a holy vision and courage in ministry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all legal professionals, attorneys, the judges, may God bless their efforts to seek truth and justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For parishioners of St. Zachary, may God give us the grace to become a cheerful giver to the church and to those in need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, may God grant them eternal rest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, your grace and mercy are all we need, yet you lovingly receive our requests. Hear this petition and answer them according to your holy will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, God of creation, for the goodness we have to receive the bread we offer you, through the fruit of the earth and the work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, God of creation, for the goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Now for you.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving that thanks, he gave it to his disciples, and saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in the remembrance of me." Mystery of faith,
we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving and thanking that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread it throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis of Pope and Grace of the Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all baptized for mercy. Welcome and pen to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, and most his father, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Zachary, with St. Lawrence, and all the saints that please you, God, in it, we may marry to be coerced into the life, and may praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, and in the union of the Holy Spirit, O glory and forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and that by the help of your mercy may we always be from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Thank you.
Bible. The 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 Bible Christ. 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 The Bible Christ.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.